Live, the news you count on, NBC2 News at 11.
This morning, NBC2 is following four scenes that are all connected. Right now, you're looking at video from Lee Memorial Hospital. You can see crime scene tape is up surrounding the emergency room. There's also a Cadillac with bullet holes in it.
Also, our crews capturing EMS, a helicopter, even a fire rescue boat, all searching in a canal. This was near Canal Street and Veronica Shoemaker Boulevard.
And check this out. This is from Highland and South Street. Lee County deputies and Fort Myers police are working together on this. Our NBC2 crews heard choppers here as well, and they saw a car that was crashed. Really just a scary way for a lot of people to wake up. This morning, our NBC2 team has been pushing for answers, but right now we can confirm that these scenes are connected.
We have been on this all day. Our team on scene since 4 a.m. Our reporter Ashley Dyer is live right now at Edison and Royal Palm, where one scene just cleared not too long ago. Ashley, what's the very latest?
Yeah, guys, so the scene here clearing not long ago, as you said, but earlier this morning and for hours, there were evidence markers just scattered all along Edison Avenue. The road here is open now to drivers. It's been open for a little bit of time. Let's take some video so we can show you what this area looked like this morning. For hours, Edison was completely blocked off from Royal Palm, where we are, down to Jackson Street, which is about two blocks down. We counted a total of 32 bullet casings laying here in the street. People who live nearby tell us they woke up in a panic as the sound of gunfire rang out loud and clear.
So what did it sound like?
4th of July. That's a little nerve-wracking, a little bit. You know, I'm kind of used to it. Unfortunately, I shouldn't have to say that, but, you know, just the way things are nowadays.
Now, I just spoke with police, and they tell me they are investigating. Again, where we are, this was just earlier this morning, just one of four scenes that we know are all related. As soon as we get any new information, we're going to bring it your way. I'm live in Fort Myers, Ashley Dyer, NBC2.